here again with my mate, Sid. Needs a good meal, to be honest. And we're going to be looking at dynamic sling anatomy with the skeleton and the band. So your outer unit musculature, or dynamic myofascial slings, which traverse the pelvis and help create pelvic stability, belong with teams of muscles, and they all sit outside your primary sling, which is your core system. So looking here, we have the anterior oblique sling. That's coming from here, looking at your external obliques, coming through to your internal obliques, and then coming down onto your adductor group. So that's forming a nice diagonal pattern coming across the body here. You have one then running on the other side. So that's coming across the body and down onto the inner thigh. This creates stability across the pelvis for our force closure. The lateral sling, we're looking at a muscle here, which is called QL. Sits just there, poking between the pelvis and the ribs. We've got our glute med, which sits on this side. And we've got our inner thigh again, running down here. So that's really essential for our one leg stability. Here, outside, inner thigh. Towards the back, we've got our posterior oblique sling, and those are the lats sitting there, actually coming off the arm. We've got thoracodorsal fascia, which sits over this area, and it comes and connects in the glute max. So in a nice diagonal line, it looks like this over the back of the body. And then we have it crossing on the other side. Now, these lines will then continue down on the side of the thigh as well into biceps femoris. So we have a diagonal line crossing over the pelvis, posterior oblique sling, one down the side with QL working on this contralateral side here, and then we have our anterior sling. And they all work together in teams. They don't work in isolation to help stabilize the hip and pelvic region, so you have great stability and movement for your dancing.